Most of us who have taken the red pill have felt isolated or worn out from time to time. The darkness at the bottom of the rabbit hole is very hard on the psyche and the soul. Those who have not yet been red-pilled cannot even begin to imagine the depths of the evil aligned against us. You cannot possibly imagine the size of this, Q posted on March 10th, but we are not alone. We are all connected in this fight. Patriots, unite. As Q posted on February 21st, patriot, a person who loves, supports, and defends his or her country and its interests with devotion. A person who regards himself or herself as a defender, especially of individual rights, against presumed interference by the federal government. Traitor, a person who betrays another, a cause, or any trust. A person who commits treason by betraying his or her country. On March 10th, Q also posted this photo of Vatican priests and Nazis calling the New World Order the Nazi Order, and Q's use of the words Sum of All Fears calls to mind the 1991 book by Tom Clancy, which was released days before the August 1991 coup, which signaled the dissolution of the Soviet Union. The 2002 film of the same name was about a neo-Nazi plot to trigger a nuclear war between the United States and Russia. Put the pieces of the puzzle together. Where do you think we would be right now if Hillary, Rothschild's choice, was in the White House? And you simply won't believe how horrible the Nazi world conspiracy really is. As Q says, truth will shock the world. If you've ever heard the rumors that Angela Merkel is the daughter of Adolf Hitler, you may have dismissed it as preposterous. Not so fast. Also on March 10th, Q posted Angela Dorothea Kaesner, daughter of a pastor, name of father, history of father, Hitler Youth member, haircut today versus then, symbolic. U.S. intelligence post-war controlled who? The mission. Who is Angela Hitler? Relationship to Adolf. How were children named in Germany during this period? First or middle? Family tree. Anna, Maria, Alois. Examples. Risk of conspiracy label the deeper we go. Truth will shock the world. And according to this anon on 8chan, false identity. Soon after the birth of Hitler's baby, an agreement between the Soviets, the Americans, and the Vatican was arranged. Hitler's baby was placed under the control of the Catholic Church through its connections with the GDR Lutheran Church, which took custody of the baby. She was given a false date of birth, July 17th, and the name Angela Dorothea Kaesner, daughter of Horst Kaesner, a Lutheran pastor, and his wife, Erland, an English and Latin teacher. There in the countryside at Templin in East Germany, Merkel was raised about 50 miles north of Berlin, the capital of the Socialist German Democratic Republic, GDR. The central theme of the agreement of the Western-aligned powers, the Vatican, and the Soviets, was that Hitler's daughter would be elevated to international power, but her ascendancy to power would not come until, quote, the Vatican also brought to power a German pope, end quote. In the wake of the death of Pope John Paul II, the former German Nazi, Joseph Ratzinger, was nominated. He took the name of Pope Benedict XVI on April 20th, 2005, as Vicar of Rome. Is it a coincidence that this date was the anniversary of Adolf Hitler's birthday? In 1977, Angela Dorothea Kaesner became Angela Merkel with her marriage to physicist Erich Merkel. But the marriage ended in divorce in 1982. She was elected Chancellor of Germany shortly after Pope Ratzinger assumed the leadership of the Roman Catholic Church on Hitler's birthday. Do you believe in coincidences? Again, as Q also posted on March 10th, this is not about religious or party affiliation. Evil is everywhere. There are no drawn lines, no boundaries. Good versus evil. So how bad is it? Recall the Pizzagate allegations of child sex trafficking and satanic ritual abuse of children involving Washington, D.C. elite, such as John and Tony Podesta, James Alefantis, and the Clintons. Q says, the spirit cooking is bigger than you know. Follow Maria, referring to satanic witch Abramovic. And Q says, there is a reason the word conspiracy was made, pushed, their weapon against the awakening. And in the same post, Q says, they made many current former enslaved children famous. Hollywood is filled with them. Models, find the loudest voices, to which Chrissy Teigen's Twitter war with Liz Crokin pops to mind. Q says, brainwashed. Who was adopted? Who was born in? They thought the sheep would follow the stars. Also on March 10th, Q stated that Friday's announcement that Goldman Sachs CEO and Uber criminal Lloyd Blankfein is stepping down, resigning, by the end of the year, is tied to Cohen and was not Blankfein's choice. Pawn was used, Q says. And now for the Q posts related to Barry Satoro, the treacherous CIA creation. Q shared this 2015 video clip of retired U.S. Admiral James Lyons, and Q wrote, "Such warnings fall on deaf ears, but not with this administration."
The Obama administration has a strategy. It's very simple. Any thinking American should be able to grasp it. It's anti-American, anti-Western, it's pro-Islamic, it's pro-Iranian, and pro-Muslim Brotherhood.
When Trump is done, it will be like Barry Satoro was never even here, says Q. There is so much going on, including a cat and mouse game with Edward Snowden, in which Q clearly has the upper hand, with Q posting pictures, and this on March 8th, at Snowden, we can take you anytime. But back to Barry. Q posted this picture of President Trump pointing his finger at Barry Satoro's chest with the caption, "When I'm done, it'll be like you were never even here." With Q concluding that, when we're done, he'll claim Kenyan citizenship as a way to escape. Meanwhile, Q reminds us Secretary Tillerson just flew to Nairobi to meet with Kenyan leadership to discuss ways to work together to counter terrorism and advance peace and security. Do you believe in coincidences? How many coincidences does it take before it's mathematically impossible? And let's round out this update with more good news. President Trump has in the past often referred to the U.S. Navy sailor who was prosecuted and jailed for taking personal photos aboard a nuclear sub. Meanwhile, the president has noted Hillary Clinton and Uma Abedin committed far, far worse crimes against the United States. Well, that U.S. Navy sailor's name is Christian Saucier.
And it's clear, I think, now to the American people that these Huma Abedin emails come out where she sent them to gave them access to a pedophile, that there was clearly some cover up within the FBI and the DOJ at the very same time that they were prosecuting me.
And on Friday, March 9th, President Trump issued a pardon for Navy sailor Christian Saucier and a tweet. "Congratulations, Christian Saucier, a man who has served proudly in the Navy, on your newly found freedom. Now you can go out and have the life you deserve." There's so much more Q to cover. Catch up on the latest for yourself, including President Trump's brilliant game of chess with North Korea, the Clinton Foundation and Haiti child trafficking, and much more at QAnonPosts.com.